One of the main reasons, in fact, the most important reason that people are learning languages these days is because of what we call globalization. Globalization simply means that with the growth of the internet and with developments in telecommunications technology, it's possible for people to do business anywhere in the world at any time. It's more important than ever to be speaking each other's languages and to do business in each other's languages as well. So that really raises the question, within our companies, who should we focus on in terms of providing corporate language programs? Of course, it'd be great for everyone to have access to language programs to be able to learn the language of their choice. Sometimes that isn't feasible, however, and I'd suggest that there may be two groups within your organization that might especially benefit from language learning programs. The first would be managers, and by managers I mean those who really know the company very well, and as research shows, are likely to be those who will actually communicate either with partners or new business enterprises internationally. So managers are important not only to be able to communicate business, but also to communicate something of the culture and the ethos of the company and how you do business, not only the business that you do. And so for managers, it will be important to be able to communicate in those languages. Another group that I would focus on would be supervisors. That is those within the company who may be working with employees who may not speak the language of your company as a first language. And you may be supervising those individuals, and it may be helpful for you to learn something of their language and also to provide corporate language programs that provide what would be a native language for your company. So everyone would be great, but I'd focus, I think, on managers and supervisors especially. One of the reasons for focusing on supervisors, too, is that if you're in a manufacturing setting, sometimes accidents can occur because we don't understand each other very clearly. And in order to maintain safety, language can be really important there as well. So what is it that you want to include in a language learning program? Well, I think we all know that English is at least one of the languages that is used universally. And most companies are beginning to offer English language learning programs, and I would certainly reinforce that idea. But I referred to globalization, and one of the things that has happened in globalization is that there are other language groups that are beginning to be major players in international business. I was just in Brazil a while ago, and I began to realize that Portuguese is becoming an important international global language, as of course is Chinese and Russian as well. So there are some really strategic languages that are important to learn if, in fact, we're going to do business worldwide, to be able to prepare ourselves to do business worldwide. So English certainly is important, but we're seeing this tremendous resurgence of languages other than English, a few that I mentioned, and undoubtedly others as well. So how do you go about delivering these language learning programs? A couple of things that I just want to mention very quickly, and I think the key word is for them to be scalable. And by scalable, I mean offering a generous number of languages, especially languages that are going to be critical for your company and your organization, but also scalable in terms of how they're delivered. You should be able to deliver them online. You should be able to deliver them through a variety of devices with apps to download. Even if in your automobile or in your car, you can have an audio CD of some kind. So to be able to have access for everyone or for a select group, scalability is important. The last thing I'd say is to make sure that you track the progress of people in the program. There are going to be those for whom it's important to learn languages, and I know of a couple of companies that are actually establishing minimum hour requirements. In other words, if you don't use the hours that you're allocated, you lose those hours. So track it, make sure that it's effective, make sure that it's meeting your goals, and in that way contribute to the globalization of business and to be able to participate in it and to profit from it.